What's good? I'm Wood. Triple G, Gennady Golovkin versus Sal Canelo Alvarez. I'm pretty surprised that they even made this fight. Canelo is clearly the money fighter here and has been Golden Boy Promotions' golden goose for the past few years. He didn't have to take this fight, and that's not to say that he's been ducking any of the top competition. He's already fought Mayweather, Cotto, Arislandi Lara, Alfredo Angulo, James Kirkland, Austin Trout. You'd be hard-pressed to find a fighter who's fought tougher competition over the past 7 years. But shoot, hats off to him and Golden Boy Promotions for making this one happen. Because if Canelo truly wants to be a middleweight champion, then he does need to fight the best in the division. Now, I think that this is a bit of a mismatch, and I have Triple G winning this one by knockout or by stoppage. And this isn't a knock to Canelo. He's absolutely one of the top pound-for-pound fighters out there. He did conquer the junior middleweight division, beating all contenders aside from never having fought one of the Charlo brothers and losing the fight to Mayweather, but he has not yet proved himself at middleweight. His only two fights at middleweight have been versus future Hall of Famer Miguel Cotto, which he won in a close fight, and versus the underachieving part-time fighter Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. So let's look at these Canelo wins at middleweight. Miguel Cotto has had some success in middleweight, knocking out a very lethargic Daniel Gill in a catchweight scenario, forcing Gill to drop an extra couple pounds, and then stopping Sergio Martinez in what would be the final fight in Martinez's career. But let's be real, Miguel Cotto is not and has never been a true middleweight. He's actually closer to Mayweather or Mosley's size than he is to a middleweight. He was even a small junior middleweight when he moved up from 147 to 154, and he lost to Austin Trout over there, and then he moved even higher to middleweight and was way smaller than any of his opponents. He was competitive with Canelo because he's a great fighter, but they were at least one full weight class apart in terms of their natural size. Then, Canelo's other middleweight victory was against a dehydrated Chavez Jr. who had to shrink an extra 10 plus pounds from where he had been fighting to even make the required weight. He looked like a skeleton during the weigh-in and looked absolutely awful during the fight. Barely throwing any punches, he looked extremely slow. It was amazing that he was even able to go the distance in that fight because he was getting hit with flush Canelo punches from the opening bell to the closing bell. Which raises another issue. How many rounds do you think that same Chavez Jr. would have lasted in the ring had he been fighting Golovkin and not Canelo? Now, Canelo is a strong puncher, but he has been forced to go the distance versus much smaller fighters than Golovkin, such as Mosley, Lara, Trout, and others. I just question whether his punching power can have a devastating effect on a true middleweight opponent. And he's not fighting just any middleweight. He's fighting an all-time great, one of the hardest punchers boxing has ever seen. Triple G is just a different animal, an undefeated fighter who's only gone the distance once in his past 23 fights. All other 22 fights were knockouts. Bottom line, no one is just taking a bunch of Triple G punches over the course of 12 rounds. There's also been this myth that Triple G's skills are eroding because he went the distance in his last fight with another big, strong, fast, skilled, true middleweight, Danny Jacobs. Let's be clear, no one that Canelo has beaten would have beaten Danny Jacobs. In fact, if Jacobs and Canelo were to announce a fight, I'd be among the first in line to put money on Jacobs. He's bigger than Canelo, faster, hits harder, moves around the ring better. So the fact that Jacobs lost to Triple G by a competitive decision and not by knockout tells me nothing about how Triple G will fare versus the much smaller Canelo. Don't get it twisted, Triple G is still a beast, who just happened to fight the second best middleweight in the world in his very last fight. So as I mentioned, I've got Triple G by knockout or stoppage in this one. I think that his fight style should give Canelo all types of problems. While Canelo is a very sharp, accurate puncher, who throws beautiful combinations, Triple G moves around the ring better than Canelo, and I'll look for him to use that mobility to cut the ring off on Canelo, apply pressure, and if he can land that stiff jab on Canelo, then this will be one painful night for the guy, because the jab can open up so much of his arsenal of power punches. So let's talk about those power shots. While Triple G does have that knock you out of your shoes type of power, it's the way that he sets those punches up and varies the punches that makes him so effective. He changes the speed on his punches, both upstairs and downstairs. He hovers over his opponent somewhat, and he's excellent at measuring distance and range. He'll throw a left cross disguised as a jab, and then will touch you upstairs with a decoy, half-speed, straight right hand, just to set up a full-speed left hook to the body, which has knocked the stuffing out of several of his opponents. Now, I do expect Canelo to land a good amount of shots on Golovkin. As I mentioned, he does throw very sharp, crisp, and accurate punches. And they do have some pop on them, just as James Kirkland, Liam Smith, and the much smaller Amir Khan. I just don't expect those punches to have the same effect on Golovkin that Golovkin's punches will have on Canelo. In the past couple of years, we've seen some big guy versus little guy experiments that did not end up going well for the little guy. Amir Khan got knocked out cold, challenging the bigger Canelo, and then the then undefeated former 147-pound champion Kell Brook got his orbital bone broken in a TKO throwing the towel loss to Triple G. Here's the thing, I just don't think that Canelo's boxing advantage, if he is even the more skilled boxer between the two, is great enough to offset the power gap between the two. If the total punches landed is even close, which I don't imagine those numbers being a blowout in favor of Canelo, then how the hell can Canelo sustain that type of punishment over the course of 12 rounds? I just don't see it. I've got Triple G by knockout or stoppage. Props, though, to Canelo for accepting the challenge by fighting the most dangerous guy in the sport and competing to be the best middleweight in the world. I can't wait. So let me know your thoughts. I'm Woog. Thanks for tuning in.